Party time is over, or is the fun just beginning? Bowl week turns to a work day. Time for another memorable Capital One Bowl. Darren McFadden is the nation's most explosive back. The Heisman runner-up is one of the fastest and strongest hogs in history. And today, he starts his 2007 Heisman campaign here in Orlando. For Wisconsin, P.J. Hill is the next in line of great Badger backs. The kid from Queens has made Madison his own and has proven he knows how to play Big Ten power football. The country's freshman of the year is nearly impossible to stop and will go over, around, or through anything in his path. Senior quarterback John Stocco looks to end his Wisconsin career with one more big win. Today, it's the Big Ten and the SEC. Power and speed, Wisconsin and Arkansas, coming up next. A sea of red in Orlando, no matter which team you're cheering for. Welcome to ESPN's presentation of Capital One Bowl, featuring the Badgers of Wisconsin from the Big Ten and the Arkansas Razorbacks of the SEC. Taylor Melhoff's got it teed up for the Badgers of the Big Ten, and maybe the most dangerous kickoff return duo in the country are right there. Felix Jones and Darren McFadden. Capital One Bowl. Happy New Year from Orlando. Here we go. Line drive. It'll be scooped up at the 12. And it's McFadden. And Darren's got it out across the 30.
66, Tony Hugo, Remington finalist, center, Jonathan Luigs. The real Ocho Cinco, Marcus Monk, receiver. Heisman finalist, Darren McFadden, number 5.
That's Darren McFadden, number 5, Felix Jones, number 25, and Marcus Monk, number 85. First down for the Razorbacks. Play action. Dick wants to go deep down the middle. Overshot his intended receiver, Robert Johnson.
Defensive line, we have the leader up front, Joe Monty. The other two linebacker spots are held down by my partners in crime, DeAndre Levy and Jonathan Casillas. And locking it down in the secondary at the safety spots, Roderick Rogers and Joe Stellmacher.
Mark, we miss the Mohawk. Got the regular haircut working. On second and 10, the throw is complete, and it's out to Robert Johnson, and Johnson's got a first down. So Arkansas comes out throwing.
Interesting that the first two plays of the game were passes to away from Monk and to Johnson, the wide receiver.
Now it's McFadden. He might be gone on the first carry of the day. Darren McFadden dragged down inside the 10-yard line. Jack Akagwagnu saved a touchdown. Now the Wildcat set, and Wisconsin.
Now they're back to where Casey Dick back under the center as the quarterback.
And he gives it off to McFadden, straight up the middle. And he only got about 2.
Yeah, wouldn't you like to own that, Kennel?
And that's Jones in motion. They fake it to him on play action. Dick wants to go to the end zone. And incomplete. Nice coverage and good. Darren McFadden now checks in the Arkansas lineup. It's third and goal at the Wisconsin 13. Badgers trying to prevent an early score here from the Razorbacks. Casey Dick across the middle, tipped, and almost caught. Nice job defensively. Jeremy Davis will try a 30-yard field goal to try to cap Arkansas's opening march. The kick on the way. And it's no good. High and a little bit to the right. So Wisconsin gets a break there. Beckham, number 9, who just shifted over into the slot on the right side as the big play receiver for Wisconsin. Stocco, play action. He wants it all on the opening play. And caught at midfield. Diving catch by Beckham. Well, I mentioned number 9. Wisconsin, the home team, by the way, in the red jerseys. Arkansas and the whites. First down. P.J. Hill is going to be dumped for a loss. Unceremoniously dumped for a loss.
Prior to the snap, false start. Number 9 on the offense. 5-yard penalty. Remains first down.
So it's first down at 15. Empty backfield as Hill flushes out, and Stocco will drop to throw. John goes over the middle, completes it to Beckham again. He's back to about the original line of scrimmage. We're
going to get things going today on the offensive line with the big man, Joe Thomas, left tackle. In the backfield, we got P.J. Hill. He's going to get it going for us at receiver. We got the Fenimore Flash, Luke Swan, and Spider-Man Paul Hubbard. And then at tight ends, we got the playmaker, Travis Beckham, and Andy Crooks.
And he's already found Travis Beckham twice on this opening drive. Second down and 10 now. Co-team MVP John Stocco, the senior, out of Richfield, Minnesota. Back to throw again. And in trouble, got rid of it, and a diving catch made.
Nope. Left arm comes back underneath the ball. Here, watch the left arm.
if the official gets out of the way.
He didn't.
And then, well, but his left arm gets underneath the ball. You see, up it.
The pass was incomplete. Yeah. It will be third down.
Starting with the line, we have the grandpa of the unit, Keith Jackson. Moving on to linebackers, we have the leader of our unit, Sam Olajabutu. And moving on to the secondary, the strongest man probably on the defense, Chris Houston.
Chris Houston will be in play here, probably, for Wisconsin on a third down at 10. Stocko going deep. Diving attempt, flags are down. I think they're going to call holding maybe on Arkansas. Luke Swan.
Oh, just stands back there.
Interference, number four on the defense. 15-yard penalty from the line of scrimmage. First down.
First and 10, Wisconsin out the Arkansas 36-yard line. P.J. Hill hit immediately. Got maybe a yard.
Five-man defensive line for Arkansas.
Hill flushes out of that backfield again. Estaco on second and nine, getting pressure. John trying to buy himself some time and throws. Almost intercepted.
They really are confident in those five guys up front.
Three receivers for Stocko on third and long. Steps up in the pocket. Deep middle. In and out of the hands. Taylor Melhoff has hit a 51-yard field goal this year. His career long. He's going to try from 52 right here. On the way. And he got it. How about that? Second team Big Ten performer shows why. 52-yard kick. Badgers on top of the Capital One Bowl by a field goal. Felix Jones and Darren McFadden. Line drive, just drilled it, and Jones mishandles it at the five. Now he's got the handle, and he's got some room. Across the 20, out to about the 24-yard line. On the end around, he's got great speed across midfield, still on his feet. Felix Jones might be gone. He is. Touchdown Arkansas, 76 yards. And he's the other running back, the guy that Paul talked about to open up the game. Just that quickly, the lead changes, and Arkansas leads Wisconsin 7-3. On an explosion with 9:19 to go in the first quarter.
A little bit.
The kick, very short, taken at about the 21. And out almost to the 40 is Tyler Holland. Nice job by Felix Jones to give his team the lead for the first time at 7-3. Stocko on the sprint out, throws to Swan, and Swan's got it, only about a 3-yard gain.
And Houston certainly was on the hot seat and had another great year at Arkansas.
Second down and 7, Stocko off play action, in trouble, and down he goes. Great pressure up the middle, and it's Keith Jackson Jr. And now it's third down and 17. Stocko, pressure coming again. Down he goes again. And this time, it's Jamal Anderson for Wisconsin. First punt of the ball game. Oh, and he just barely got it out of there. Not a bad kick. Fish calls for the fair catch, and he'll field it at about the 33-yard line.
Mustaine is in now at quarterback.
We expected it in the third series, and Mitch, the true freshman, is in there at the 34-yard line. And a little counter to McFadden. And Wisconsin had it sniffed out pretty well.
Yeah.
Gus Malzahn, the offensive coordinator, said he's about 90%. I want to see him at 100% because when he got through that line.
And all these other unique defenses, wasn't quite like high school.
Here he is on third and nine, though. Waits and fires, and he's got his man. First down across midfield, Cedric Washington. So the battle will continue for quarterback into next year. Here's McFadden. And did the ball come out? It did. Mustaine scoops it up and runs out of bounds. Second down and 7. You look behind Mitch in the Arkansas offense. Fish in motion. The gives to Jones. This time Wisconsin's got it wrapped up pretty well. Let's see if they pass here on third down at 6. At the Wisconsin 44. They will. Try to throw a little screen. And Wisconsin read it beautifully. High kick. Fair catch. Taken back at about the 9-yard line for Wisconsin. And Barry is out at the Fiesta Bowl. He'll be working the championship game in the Fiesta Bowl for our friends at Fox as a color analyst. So he had mixed emotions about not being with his team. See if he protects his quarterback if John Stocco chooses to throw here. Second down and nine. Stocco is near his own end zone. Got pressure. Incomplete. Tip.
Five-man defensive line.
Luke Swan in motion for Wisconsin. And he gets the pass across the middle from Stocco, and it's a first down, Wisconsin.
Arkansas stacking up. They're saying to you, okay, Wisconsin, you throw the ball. You're not going to run it.
From the 21, they try to run it, and going nowhere is P.J. Hill. Swan in motion on second down at 12. Arkansas might have jumped into the neutral zone. Could be a free play. Stocco, the throwback, incomplete, intended for P.J. Hill. But
offside for 97 on the defense. 5-yard penalty. Repeat second down.
Trying to become only the third first-year coach ever to win 12 games in his opening season. Here's a pass across the middle, and it's Paul Hubbard. And Hubbard's all the way out near midfield, and another Badger first down. Actually popped the ball loose from Hubbard, but Hubbard got the big gainer out to the 48-yard line. Stocco, the out to Swan. Nice catch. Diving catch. There's the five-man front that Bob's circling. Stocco, great play fake. Still got the ball, and nobody knows it except Crooks, the tight end. Inside the 30, down to the 22-yard line. Boy, John Stocco. I can't see Jim Mandich ever falling down for you, Bob. From
got
the 22.
Throwing down.
Stocco to Beckham, and he almost made the catch. Nice coverage with a half minute to go in the first quarter, but threatening at the Arkansas 22. Stocco going to loft it to the corner. He's got a man. Touchdown, Wisconsin. Paul Hubbard. They call him Spider-Man, and he just slung a web out there and caught that baby in the corner of the end zone.
Drive dominated with passes for Wisconsin.
Melhouse's extra point is up and good. So we seesaw Wisconsin back in front, capping a 91-yard march. Can take it the distance at any given moment on a kick return. This one will bounce at the 12. McFadden will scoop it at the 5. And Darren's out across the 20 to about the 21-yard line. But now it's the senior back there leading the squad.
Casey Dick is back in at quarterback.
And he's going to throw on first down. Complete out across the 30 and to about the 35 is Robert Johnson. Darren McFadden and Felix Jones on one side, John Stocco and Paul Hubbard and Luke Swan on the other. You're watching the Capital One Bowl from Orlando, Florida. A good first quarter. Stick around. It's Wisconsin 10-7.
We were watching that Green Bay game last night.
You got that right. Yeah. And what might have been Brett Favre's in the lounge at the hotel.
False start. By the right side of the line, our penalty remains first down.
Got my grandkids.
Paul's a big guy, yeah.
Early, we don't necessarily know what early means. And Wisconsin doing a nice job on defense.
Wisconsin doing it through the air, and Arkansas doing it on the ground.
Casey Dick coming up firing, and short gain. Wisconsin does a nice job on that crossing pattern. That's why the Badgers have the lead 10-7. Third down, 13. Casey Dick steps up and fires incomplete. Long wait for the snap, and Skinner with the kick hangs it up high. Nice punt. Fieldable, though, at the 27 and back to about the 37. Michigan and Wisconsin tied for second in the Big Ten. Arkansas, the SEC West champions. Here's P.J. Hill. P.J. hasn't been able to get much cooking so far. That's his best run of the day. Second down at 5. From behind, P.J. Hill. And here he comes. And down he goes. They're not giving him any room.
He's got to throw the ball more to get P.J. Hill involved.
He'll be throwing here. Empty backfield. Third and 4. Stocco pumps across the middle. Tipped. Crooks trying to make a diving catch off the ricochet. Down with a hug for his dad. Congratulations to Bob Knight. Block punt. There's nobody back there but Badgers right now. The guy that blocked it's trying to come up with it. And now the throw. Open man is there. Flags are down. all over the field. That's one of the zaniest plays you'll see.
Ineligible receiver downfield, number 57 on the offense, 5-yard penalty from the line of scrimmage, repeat fourth down.
Again, Wisconsin, I'm sure, will try to protect him a little better. The kick. Fish takes it and goes down in deep water. Zach Hampton.
What a huge break that was for Wisconsin. They gained about 50 hidden yards from where the ball would have been to where Arkansas takes possession of it right now.
Now McFadden.
Stop a run.
McFadden split out to the bottom of your screen as a wide receiver. And it's Felix Jones, the tailback. And Jones available in bookstores nationwide. Casey Dick back to throw on third down, buying himself some time and throwing and completing out to Marcus Monk, or do they say incomplete? Jacob Skinner to punt.
You see Skinner's little ritual before he punts the ball?
Yeah, he's got to line it up. This one he lined up way up in the air. And Hampton will fair catch it. 5 carries, 5 yards for a guy that had over 1,500 on the season. Nice play fake by Stocko, and he's going to run with it. Stocko across the 40, and he gets out for about 5 yards. And John's right behind him, trying to win number 29 today. Here he is on the rollout. And there's going to be a holding call.
Yeah, he tackled.
Yeah, basically, P.J. Hill got tackled.
Yeah, it was.
10-yard penalty from the line of scrimmage. First down.
At the 47-yard line, Wisconsin with a first down. Stocko play action. Here comes a heat from behind. Somehow he got out of there and now throws it away. Does a nice job just getting rid of the ball. Happy New Year to everybody. And right now, the Wisconsin fans just a little bit happier than Arkansas with a 3-point lead. P.J. Hill puts his head down. And third down.
And the other people, I don't know who they are.
Third down and 5. You got Lawrence Welk over here, and you got, here's Stocko to throw, and Hubbard goes up and gets it.
Wow.
What a catch. Second big one of the day for Hubbard. One was a touchdown. So in the red zone, Wisconsin with 7 and change remaining in the quarter. They fake the end around. Stocko's got to get rid of it, and he took a pretty good shot.
I'll tell you what.
So far, he hasn't hit his big play tight end, Beckham, as he drops back to throw here. Flares it out to Luke Swan. And Swan is inside the 15. Seventh play of the Badger drive. And it's third down at 5.
All man coverage. Everybody up near the line of scrimmage.
Stocko, quick drop. Throws to the end zone. Beckham. Got it. Touchdown, Wisconsin.
That a great throw.
Both the possession and the foot. Watch his right foot right here.
He's got
it right there.
Hand.
He's got possession before. Yeah.
Yep. He's got his right toe in, outstretched hand to the defender. It's a touchdown. And now the Badger fans can celebrate again. Side of the booth.
Whoa. On that one play, you didn't say, you didn't hear me say it. Well, I don't know.
The extra point is up and good. And Wisconsin leads 17-7. John Stocko, senior, playing his last game for the Badgers. 2 touchdown passes so far.
Allowing his man to make the catch.
This kickoff is deep. After line driving a few, they knocked that one in the end zone. Arkansas, the SEC, at its own 20-yard line. Fish in motion. Here's McFadden. And Darren goes for 5 yards.
That's pretty good
company. Pretty good company.
Yes, sir.
Herschel joined us on ESPN on the Chick-fil-A Bowl the other night. He looks like he can still play. He was down on the sideline watching. Jones now is a slot man on the right and comes back in motion. And they give it to him on the end around. Felix Jones across the 40 and out to the 46-yard line. Another Arkansas first down. So way back in the day at Auburn, it was Cribbs as the run this time into Wisconsin territory.
Lined up as a fullback, weighs 280 pounds. Ex-guard.
Casey Dick throwing high that time, trying to get it to Marcus Monk. Now it's third down. Here's the pitch, loose ball. They found the handle. Ikeguagnu, though, brings down Felix Jones.
That.
Never.
Skinner to punt. Oh, and he got it blocked. He lined it up wrong, but Wisconsin had it lined up beautifully. Ben Strickland with a block punt, and the Badgers have the ball in Arkansas territory. Plenty of time to work before halftime. 2:45 in the second quarter. Stocko might want to go on top right here. Steps up in the pocket. Now scrambling, trying to get away from the rush. He's going to get positive yardage as he goes out in front of the Arkansas bench. Both wideouts to Stocko's right. He's looking that way and now wants to come back with a screen to Crooks, and it's intercepted by Arkansas, and it's Keith Jackson, the big guy on the front wall, and you know his daddy's having a big time in the booth to our right now.
Hello, Hoss. How you doing, boy?
Play action, the end around now to Darren McFadden, and he's trying to get the corner, and he got it out of bounds at about the 48. There's Darren in the backfield.
The Hogs need a score.
They fake it to McFadden. Casey Dick going deep down the middle. Ooh, big hit. Robert Johnson knew he was going to take a shot, and Stellmacher said, you know what, I'm happy to deliver. Third down and short. Oh, I don't think so. Mark Zalewski makes the stop. Everybody on their feet for both sides here. Fourth down and one. Play action. They throw it. It's incomplete. Great play by Jonathan Casillas, the outside linebacker. They let the last one slip away on the interception by Keith Jackson. Stocko scans the field. Tipped again. Incomplete. Boy, that one could have been picked off too.
By Felix Jones earlier in the ballgame.
Stocko on second down, crossing pattern. Whoa, that's going to be a flag.
That's a 15-yarder.
Chris Houston got his hands.
Personal foul, face mask, number two on the defense, 15-yard penalty from the end of the play.
You see Paul coming across the field, and right there, maybe couldn't get it out, you never know, but he definitely brought him down by the helmet that we know.
Well,
they're going to throw again. Stocko. Across the middle again, and Beckham, it's intercepted by Houston. So the guy that just made a mistake just made a huge play.
When I was in Little League, I was the quarterback. I was 3 feet tall.
What a wonderful throw.
Yeah, but he didn't, so I said the other thing.
Casey Dick throws, and he completes it out to Johnson, and he's out of bounds in the final half minutes of the half. Johnson in motion toward the ball. Flags down. Casey Dick trying to run away from the pressure and incomplete. Again, a penalty marker. Inch. It's a motion penalty. It's Felix Jones in the backfield. He's got 91 yards, and here he comes for more. He's going to have 100 by halftime if he doesn't have a touchdown. On his way all the way down to the 40-yard line. Second big run of the day by Felix Jones. One was a touchdown. This one gives Arkansas hope.
Get some cold chills when you mention the Rose Bowl.
From the 39, Casey Dick pump fakes one way, comes back the other, trying to find Monk, and it's intercepted by Wisconsin. Inside the five, and it's Zach Hampton, who's made some big plays on special teams. And so Wisconsin with a lead in the Capital One Bowl at halftime. After beating Auburn a year ago, they've got a leg up on Arkansas, the SEC, in this 2007 edition. With Wisconsin out in front, the Capital One Bowl by 10, 17-7. We're going to send it out west now. John Saunders, Craig, and Doug. Fellas.
For a 10-point lead. My math is not too good.
Well, you went to Purdue.
Here's the kick. And it's free right now. May have touched a Badger as well. And only out. Oh, and what a whack. At the 10-yard line, that was. All right, let's see how they do to start the third quarter from their own 10-yard line. It is P.J. Hill. P.J. bouncing off guys and picked up a tough 4 yard. Second down and six. Stocko hit as he throws, and it's incomplete. Yep. Third down and six, 50% for John today, 2-2. See what he does on this third down. Quick drop and the quick slant. Luke Swan, the intended receiver, broken up. See if the Razorbacks bring pressure here. Nope, they got the return set up this time. Reggie Fish backpedals to the 40. And Fish had to cross the 45 to about the 47-yard line. At their own 47-yard line. Darren McFadden, the single setback, and he'll get the call here on first down. And Wisconsin's waiting for him. Zalewski with a tackle
Casey Dick took the other seven series.
Here's a pitch.
Jones taking
the handle to the corner and bumped out of bounds right at the midfield stripe. Mustaine in there in the shotgun. On third down. Firing complete. Nice throw inside the 40. Breaking tackle, Cedric Washington. And he's got a first down at the Badger 38. So, Roderick, we wish you the best with rehab. It'll be a while. Mustaine going up on top for Monk. And good coverage back there. Number two in the SEC at 19.4 a catch.
11 touchdowns.
Here's the Wildcat package. McFadden fakes a handoff to Jones, takes it himself. And he goes to see how accurate they are on third down here. Third down and seven for Mustaine. Play action. Mitch sets up, getting some heat. Throws incomplete. Nice job defensively by Jonathan Casillas. Skinner punts it a mile in the air.
What does...
It'll be a great kick if they can get to it. And did they? Yes. Can't do it any better than that. We want those Capital One credit cards we don't have to pay on, John. Just send them to my home address. As Stocko tries to get a little bit of breathing room.
They throw it. Probably going to be to Beckham, number nine.
And he's in motion. Here it comes. There it goes. You called it, Bob. What a great job. They're now a dangerous time here for Wisconsin. Third down and nine. From their own two-yard line. Stocko in the end zone. And he's going to get rid of it.
Ford.
And he did. Not a great kick. Fish makes the fair catch at about the 33-yard line.
Mustaine back in.
Behind him is McFadden. Darren gets the call. Nice open field tackle by Stellmacher. McFadden will take the direct snap. Fakes the handoff, now tries to follow his blockers. And Wisconsin waiting for him, and this time it's Zalewski.
Oh, man.
Now they need to make something happen.
Mustaine on third and long, throws. Whoa, tried to tuck it in there, and you talk about a collision. Stellmacher is back where he did on his last kick at the one-yard line. If he can do it twice in a row, hangs it up there, might have a shot at it. And he did. Or did it get to the end zone? It hit the end zone line. Fun contribution courtesy of Pontiac. From the 20. And a loss of four. Neither team can get the ground game going with second down at 13 now for John Stocko. P.J. Hill back in the Wisconsin backfield. Stocko rolling to throw. If he can get away. And just got to throw it away.
On their schedule, well, they've got Arkansas. Arkansas is a ranked team, and they're beating him pretty good right now.
Number six leading number 12, as you just saw. Here's a swing pass, and it's knocked down again. Nice punt.
Very nice.
Fish. Whoa! Took a shot, and then took a shot. Took a shot at catching it without the fair catch. Felix Jones back in at the tailback spot for Arkansas. Mustaine at first down, throws complete, and Monk with a catch, and that is his first of the day.
After the play was over, personal foul, late hit out of bounds, number 47 on the defense, 15-yard penalty from the end of the play, first down.
Hugo, their best lineman, the captain and the left tackle, has been in and out most of the game, and McFadden, second down and eight, pick up a two by Jones. Mustaine wants to throw it, does, completes it, but just a short gain.
Arkansas has had great field positions the last three times and has come away with no points.
They're going to give it on the end around to Jones. Now cuts back to the middle and slips down at the 30. It's fourth down and five, and they're going for it at the Wisconsin 30-yard line. Mustaine in the shotgun. Fires, and it's intercepted by Wisconsin. DeAndre Levy, the outside linebacker.
Well, that was a bad pass.
Well, no, it wasn't a bad pass.
Yeah, it was.
It was just great defensive play.
I know that, I tell you, if you thought that was a good pass, you weren't one.
At the 28, Wisconsin takes over. And P.J. Hill, it's been an uphill battle for P.J. Why am I helping you criticize me? Yeah. I don't know, partner. I'm trying to help you over here. And Arkansas's defense equal to the task. Again, a loss of a yard. And, boy, Wisconsin loves him back in his first year. I think there were some people that wondered if Barry Alvarez made the right choice by picking Brett Bielema, and it sure looks like a good one. Stocko's going to go down. Relentless pressure by Jamal Anderson. That's his third sack of the day. Today, the Bush should be returnable. Fish made the first man miss and then slid down as he got across the 35-yard line. And back with the pads on, still looking for the helmets.
Casey Dick back in at quarterback.
Here's fake Casey Dick. The play action throw completes it out across the 40 for Rod Jackson. Third down and six. Throws complete. First down and then some. Down to the 40-yard line. Lucas Miller is going into Frank Broyles, the athletic director's office, complaining about the direction of the offense as Darren McFadden goes inside the 35 to the 34-yard line. And Houston Nutt's team won 10 games this year. I think he probably knows what he's doing, don't you?
Yeah.
You're watching the Capital One Bowl from Orlando, Florida at the end of three. You come this way. You come this way.
I don't
way.
Know about this guy.
Here's McFadden trying to cut it outside, and does. He's got a first down and knocked out of bounds at about the 25-yard line. Arkansas finally with a first down. And here's McFadden out of that Wildcat package with a direct snap and going with both guys in the backfield, McFadden and Jones together. Darren will take the snap, give it off to his buddy. Jones, left side. He's got it down.
You've got to stop both of them, not just one guy.
McFadden has thrown three touchdown passes this year. From the 12-yard line, it's Jones inside the five. He's in, touchdown. 12-yard scoring run, second rushing touchdown of the day for Felix Jones.
Tackle, it's wide open.
Davis' extra point is good. As Bob said, only takes one play to be right back in the thick of things, and Felix Jones has got the Hogs hollering now. 63-yard drive capped by Felix the Cat Jones, second touchdown of the day. Three-point ball game in Orlando. Record 52-yard field goal. No first downs in a long time. And a nice kick. Josh Nettles will take a knee. He's going to throw on first down. Across the middle and big collision. The umpire and Hubbard got tangled up. Second down and 10.
That just happens sometimes. The officials are just part of the field.
Here's a toss. P.J. Hill has not been able to get anything going offensively on the ground for Wisconsin and still doesn't there.
With, and two times was negative. So long time since his team has done something positive on offense.
John Stocko hasn't completed a pass in this half. Gonna try it again. Maybe. In the pocket. Oh, big hit. Stocko sacked. Snap was a little wide. DeBush handles it. It's a line drive spiral of Fish at the 37. Flags are down as gonna be an illegal block in the back.
During the return, illegal block in the back. Number 20 on the receiving team. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. First down.
Having the kind of seasons they had, especially not P.J. Hill. 14 yards on 11 carries. Here's the end around of McFadden. Got his quarterback out there trying to block for him, and Wisconsin was reading it beautifully. And Zach Hampton, second down and 9. Casey Dick, a quick drop in the throw, out complete to the 40, trying to spin away, and doing so, Cedric Washington. Nice second effort.
Arkansas with a lot more offensive yardage than Wisconsin.
Jones all wrapped up this time. Maybe got a yard.
And Casey Dick is back in the game at quarterback.
Quick drop, pump fake, and then coming back the other way to Monk. Flags all over the place as Monk is out of bounds.
Before the ball was thrown, holding number 6 on the defense, 10-yard penalty from the line of scrimmage, first down.
These Wisconsin fans and the players don't like the heat. They're all in the pool.
That's right. When the Wisconsin offensive line went out to the pool the other day, you see 4.12 yards per play for Wisconsin. Casey Dick has got a man open across the middle. Going to be short of the first down, but again, there are flags all over the field one more time. And that is the call. The Arkansas second down and 19. Casey Dick, the play action. And fires complete. Nope, in and out of the hands of Monk. And if he'd have caught that one, now the Badger fans trying to make some noise for their defense on a third down and 19. Screen pass. Jones has got it with a wall in front of him, but he got taken off his feet at the 44-yard line. Behind Jacob Skinner as he'll punt. And again, a possibility that they'll down it inside the five. Nope, it got to the, did it get to the goal line?
And especially in the great field position Arkansas had.
Wisconsin's had 15 offensive plays in this half, minus 10 yards. Stocko on play action, look out for you-know-who. He got away from him and throws out of bounds.
You just move it.
Second down and 10 for Wisconsin. Stocko back, the quick throw. Swan trying to make a diving catch. Former Wisconsin women's basketball player. I think Annie's about 6'5". And Brett Bielema says, I'm already recruiting the kid, and they probably won't have one for a long time. If you got 6'5 and 6'8, he knows he gets his first male born. The first down for Wisconsin since there was 1:20 left in the second quarter.
Don't think that their defense isn't happy that they got that either.
Stockwell to stay in under heavy pressure. Flags down.
There are two penalties on the play. Pass interference, number 2 on the defense. Roughing the passer, number 99. Penalties are declined. Correction. The roughing the passer was on number 99 on the defense. 15-yard penalty, first down.
And that's Keith Jackson Jr. Wisconsin in front, but by only a field goal. Stocko, pressure coming. And down he goes again. Antoine Robinson, five more so far today.
Right.
Stocko going to loft one out there. Dangerous throw. It's intercepted. But there's a penalty marker down. Now, will there be a pass interference?
Pass interference. Number 4 on the defense. 15-yard penalty from the line of scrimmage. First down.
Instead of getting that arm motion straight ahead.
Hill inside the 40 to about the 38. The ball is out. Arkansas's got it back. Matero Richardson with a fumble recovery. They've got a dangerous guy in the backfield right now. And it's McFadden, but he's only got a yard. Jason Chapman made the tackle. Second down and 9. Casey Dick, nice play fake. Wanted to go for the home run, and now he's being pressured. And down he goes. First sack of the day by Wisconsin, and boy, third and 21. Down the middle, incomplete. Not a good kick, but it almost hit a Wisconsin player. Now it takes a tremendous Razorback bounce all the way down inside the 15.
Had
personal foul.
Wisconsin pin.
Number 51 on the kicking team. 15-yard penalty from the line of scrimmage. Repeat fourth down.
And again, just an end-over-end punt. And Hampton maybe should have thought about fielding that one, but this one doesn't do near the damage. As a defensive coordinator, trying to bring some pressure on Stocko and Hill. They certainly wrapped P.J. Hill up all day long. And
they were near last in the conference in takeaways this year, though.
Second down and 9. John Stocko over the middle. He's got his man. Beckham, first down and then some. Spinning his way inside to 35, and Beckham's all the way down to the 31-yard line. 24-yard pass play to the big play receiver. And now he's got his team down to the Arkansas 31-yard line. Back to P.J. Hill they go. A little bit of room on the inside for P.J. This time behind P.J. Hill in the high backfield of Wisconsin. P.J. following his fullback, bouncing off. There's a good run. He didn't get to the first down marker.
And then earlier today, Penn State of the Big Ten beat Tennessee. So everybody's kind of looking at these things and say, well, these conferences that are going head-to-head.
Two tight ends set now as P.J. Hill just want to hold on to the ball. And he's going to lose yardage.
Yeah, didn't get back to the line of scrimmage.
Especially the seniors. So let's see if they can hold on to the lead in the ball here. B.J. Hill cuts back, still dragging people with him down to about the 17-yard line.
He was in college. He was an assistant coach.
Well, I just liked the game the other night, the game we did, and Bielema come up.
10-7.
Oh, boy.
Or 7-3.
Yeah.
Should Michigan be, you know, an AP national champion?
Well,
happened before.
You just set yourself up for a question that nobody can answer. At least we don't have to because we're out of time. Or we're going to be. They're going to try a Hail Mary here, and Wisconsin's got people 60 yards deep in coverage. Here comes the ball from Casey Dick. The jump ball and batted down by Zach Hampton, who had an interception earlier. And there's a happy rookie coach. The Wisconsin Badgers survive the comeback by Arkansas, and Brett gets a bat. Winning his team now in school history, 12-1 for Wisconsin. 17-14 is the final score. And now the players, like the fans, get to do the jump. He wins his first bowl game here in Orlando, the Capital One Bowl, 17-14. Our congratulations to the Badgers of Wisconsin.